not really trying to become a rapper, but I think it's kind of funny.
Easy on that.
Behavior. Motherfuckers never trained us. Never trained us. Motherfuckers never trained us. New behavior. Motherfuckers never trained us. Never trained us. New behavior. Motherfucker, you never trained us. You never trained us. New behavior. Motherfucker, you never trained us. You never trained us. New behavior. Motherfucker. Motherfucker. You never trained us. New behavior. Motherfucker, you never trained us. You know, I just don't get it. I log in. Everything's level 1. Not even level 2. I don't even know about these leather shoes. Crapped him, he's level 3. What the fuck? I can't even reach these. That was dumb. New behavior. Motherfucker. You never trained us. You know, like, 10 minutes ago, I had a really good flow. Now it's just gone. That was nice. It was going like about levels. Now I can't just kill him. I kinda like this. I don't get it. I guess over there mining rune. I can't even mine fucking tin! New behavior. What the fuck is tin at? How do you make iron from tin? Fuck! Motherfucker. Never trained us. Never trained us. New behavior. Motherfucker. Never trained us. Never trained us. Never trained us. New behavior. Well, I'm not sure how that's gonna be fun. Let's make some crusty beats. Cause fuck you. By the way, I'm not actually, you know, like a good digi. But, I like doing it, it's fun. It's the dream. We'll be right back. Motherfuckers. Should I get some actual, like, good mixing going here? Cypress Hill. It's Black Sunday as well, like. That one. That one.
Like the bones, I'll roll you up and smoke you like corn. Split the seed.
All right. That was pretty fun. Not gonna lie. That was a good mix. That was fun. That was definitely fun. Not sure where this is gonna go. It might be on my skip channel, might be on my other channel. I think it should go on my other channel because it's more music related instead of RuneScape. But at the same time, music in the background, I don't fucking know. Never loved us. I can't wait until I can get a actual controller, and I can lose the mouse and keyboard and use the controller and be hopefully better. I don't plan on going anywhere with this besides as a hobby. It's fun, and I can multitask with it. I can play RuneScape while DJing, so it's a kind of win-win for me. So I don't lose XP. I like other instruments, which I have to go off my computer and lose XP. Yes, that is a problem when RuneScape controls my life, where I have to get a quota of XP per day, because it's 5:37 a.m. right now, and I am like 600 fish off of my daily goal of getting 1,500 monkfish a day. Until I get 10,000 monkfish, and then I'm going to switch to probably 1,000 sharks a day. Until I have like 5,000 or 6,000 sharks. I don't know how many I'm going to keep until that too. But other than that, thank you guys for watching and listening if you did. I had fun with it. Definitely probably should do more of this stuff, because I honestly enjoy it. I don't get to do much of it that often. But before I do get off, let's show you what I've been up to in the past couple days. So recently I've come to the encounter of making or wanting to make a 5-color EDH deck for Magic the Gathering, if you're lost in the dark. And that's fine. But the thing is, one, I'm poor. Two, I have a shit ton of foils that I don't need. Three, I'm gonna proxy it. And I made my own custom artwork. I'm gonna show you some. They're all backwards right now. So, yes, forgive the backwards art, because it has to be like that for when I print it off. It's, gonna be inverted, etc. But I can go into the actual folder and show you the raw file. So let me bring that up quick. They're not like amazing quality, like workmanship, but they do look really nice. I could have done a lot better to be honest, but I think they look nice for like what I had available. I'm gonna start at the beginning. I didn't do this one, but this is in my deck. If it'll load, it'd be great. Let's get some BG music on. I'll get that groove. Alright, I'm tired of quietness. There we go. Fish. I'm not sure if I'm gonna keep the really white, nerdy raps in this video. You know, if you listen to them, you listen to them. If not, you didn't miss much. You have to get 500 more fish tonight. Or I can say fuck it and do it when I wake up tomorrow or something. So this is Malstorm Rain Archangel. She's pretty sweet. I didn't do this artwork, but it's in the deck. That's a fake card. Like, it's not an actual MTG card. But I thought it was funny, so I'm going to have to put it in the deck. And then Biden Thassa Full Art. I think it looks beautiful. I didn't do it. It's a hand-painted one that I was able to find really good. I'm not sure if it's hand-painted or not. But I found a really good... scan, so I used it as that one. And then I got the Abyssal Whip of Erebos. I think that's pretty sweet. It's supposed to be just an actual whip, but I made it a Abyssal Whip. And then we have Aetherios, the God of Passage, which reminded me a lot of Yorick, because Yorick is a Gravedigger, and his ability is creatures you control, or whenever a creature you control dies, whatever the fuck, return it to your hand unless your opponent pays your life. So it's pretty much like grave digging, unless they pay life, etc. And then I used Yorick from League of Legends, and I didn't do that, but it looks nice. It's black and black. I think that's what it's supposed to stand for, which makes sense. Erebos and black and black Purphoros. Full art Brigmos, or Borborio Gobmos. I didn't do that, but it looks nice and it's in the deck. I didn't do this artwork, but it looks nice and it's in the deck. They're going to be. I think it looks freaking insane-o. Then we have Sarah Doman as Ifara, God of Polis. Getting of each cupcake if you had another cupcake. Upkeep. If you had another creature in your battlefield, you'd be last stream and draw a card. Oh, it looked nice. Especially up here, where I layered his head over the banner. I like that 3D effect. I've been doing that the last few of them, and it looks nice. We have a G-Maul for the Hammer of Prophros. I don't really care for it too much, but I thought it was funny, so I'm going to print it off. And we have the Guthix Bow of Nylia. I was going to use originally a crystal bow, but I couldn't. The crystal bow was like clear, so it wasn't going to work that good. We have Heliod God of Sun with the Cloud Sun Titan meme as the picture. That was kind of funny, so I'm doing that. We have Armadil as Irobus, God of Victory. I thought it was fitting because Boros. As Boros comes in, Armadil is pretty much Boros because it's heavy. Boros is burn aggro, and that's kind of what Armadil is sometimes. Then we have Karanos, God of Storms, or Karanos, and I'm using Forecast Janna from League. It's my favorite skin. First skin I ever bought for her. I bought it like day of release, so I fell in love with it and her in the same day, so I was just like, yay! Can't wait to play with that. And then this is the main commander I'm gonna use, Corona, False God. 5-1 colorless, or one of each and one colorless. 4-5-5 haste, beginning of each upkeep. And player intense Corona. False God. And gain control of it. So essentially what happens is each upkeep of the player, so as you're going around the table, they untap my creature and gain control of it. And whenever Corona attacks, creatures of the creature's type of your choice get D3 until end of turn. So it's amazing because other people can take her from me, or him, I'm not sure. It just has tits. So I'm saying her, and kill other people for me. So therefore, they're winning the game for me. It's so amazing. I love it. I can't wait to get this deck made. We have Vel'Koz as Krufix, God of Horizons. I love this layering I did. It's so simple. Like, incredibly, is really simple to do, but it just looks so fluid. Like, come on. I was gonna do it all the way down here with the tentacle. But at the same time, I would lose all the text, and I kind of like the text, because I don't always remember what cards do. So it's just like, oh, okay, that's cool. And we have Zamorak as Mogus, God of Slaughter. I thought that was pretty fitting, because if each upkeep, Mogus deals 2 damage to that player, unless he or she sacrifices a creature, so that's pretty brutal. And I thought that was fitting for Zamorak. I thought this layering up here was pretty sweet as well. I probably should have done it down here as well, but fuck it, I don't care. Oh well. Oh yeah, also the funny thing is, with Corona, I can, the creature type of your choice. Look at that creature type. god. I can have all my gods attack at once, and they'll be even stronger. And plus, they're indestructible. That's so fucking amazing. And I have Nylia, the God of Hunt, Woad, Ashe from League, other creatures you can run off Trample, Pay, Chuck Kidra gets 2-2 and then turn, so it's just there because Trample and, like, the gods and shit. Progenitus, 2 of each, which is insane for 10-10 protection from everything, which is amazing. So if I get this big ass fat ass out there, I'm pretty much guaranteed some damage. But if Progenitus we put into graveyard from anywhere, reveal Progenitus and shuffle it into the library. So pretty much if I discard it, it gets countered or somehow gets killed or milled, I can shuffle him back in my library, which is amazing. So he's also, I didn't do artwork by the way, but he's also a commander. This is just in the deck. The Seth of Light for the Spear of Heliod. I was going to originally use this as a Samurakian Spear, but this fits better, to be honest. And then everything gets with one, pay and destroy giant creature, blah blah blah. Thassa, God of the Sea, I used Nami from League. I thought that splash art just looked so good in this fucking card. Yeah. And she is getting a feature upkeep, scry 1, and then 1/1 creature you control can't be blocked. So that's also amazing with, like, the gods. I can make them unblockable and attack and swing out and blah blah blah. And then we have Xenagos, God of Revels. I use Bandos. I think it makes sense for Gruul. You have Bandos. Looking back at it, I probably should have made this border 100% opacity and then had his helmet poke through, but I don't give a shit because I don't really care for Bandos or Xenagos, but he is pretty good. At the beginning of each of combat on your turn, an entire creature you control gains haste and gets XX where its number of creatures' power, so it's pretty much doubling its power. Or something like that. So if you have a 10-1, it becomes a 20-11. Just saying. And then we have, that's where we are. And then, those are the cards that I did, or at least in my EDH deck. We have all the sheets I had to print out. This takes some time to do. I'm not gonna lie. These are all the other proxies I want to do. I love this Assassin's Creed Elspeth Knights Errant. It's so good. Look at those eyeballs. I think I'm gonna say those. Look at those tits. Look at those tits. They're pretty cool too. But look at that, this is so pretty. And then this full art Nico Bolas. That looks really sick. And what else we have here? We have full art Jace Mind Sculptor. I don't really care for him too much, but I can trade him off easily for a lot of value. I'm not gonna sell these cards for cash because that's illegal. Copyright claims, but what I can do is I can trade them for cards, because cards, the people, have card value instead of money value. So I can trade a Mind Sculptor for a real Mind Sculptor, theoretically, because someone might want a full art Mind Sculptor instead of the real Mind Sculptor, and then I can go to the card store or eBay and sell the Mind Sculptor for $105. That won't happen, but I can probably trade a full art foil Jace for maybe an Elspeth, or maybe even a foil Elspeth, and then that's worth $50 right there. It's a $50 bill I can sell. That would be insane, but I doubt that would happen. So yeah, that's my EDH deck I'm working on. It's gonna be so much fun. I can't wait to get that going. Alright. Thank you guys for hanging out with me. Again, I should probably get off RuneScape or something, because it's fucking late as shit. It just started out as a joke, and it went into a full video.
Thank you guys for watching. Bye.